Hello and welcome to a new video review, and this time for the Transformers Last Night Voyager Class Optimus Prime. The Transformers Last Night toy line has been released in Germany a few days ago, and I think this is great, because I remember times when Germany ended up being pretty late receiving toy lines from Transformers. And this time we're head-to-head with United States, I think. And, yeah, the bad thing is the prices have been increased. So, right now we're paying around 43 euros for Voyager class figure, which is, as far as I remember, around 46 US dollars. And I think that's pretty insane. I remember times when a Voyager class figure had cost around 33 euros. First, I want to take a look at the packaging for this figure, which you got over here. Here we have a nice artwork of Optimus Prime in robot mode, the Transformers Last Night logo. Here on the side, the Transformers logo, this little button, Premier Edition. What is Premier Edition? I can't exactly say. I think it's a rebrand to Generations to mark the figures for the adult collectors and grown-up kids. So this figure is 8 years plus. Okay, so yeah, it's the typical Transformers toy we know. Also, there are some for kids, like Fast Action Battlers. I forgot how they are named now. Also, Legion class and so on. So this is real deal. This is the stuff we grown-up collectors look for, and we have here Optimus Prime in his robot mode and in his truck mode. Here we have Grimlock, the other Voyager class figure in Wave 1. But what I dislike about Grimlock is that he's just a repaint from the Age of Extinction Grimlock, and that is my biggest problem with the Last Night toy line, because right now about I guess 80% of the figures seem to be repaints from older toy line, from older series of movie toys. I think this Optimus Prime turns out pretty well. Here we have another artwork of the movie Optimus Prime here. Good so far. The instruction booklet is redone compared to the Age of Extinction toys, because you fold it out like a poster or something, but this is gonna fold out like this. You have a long stripe of paper with instructions on it. Otherwise, the design is pretty neat. Yeah, but I want to show you the figure, which is far more interesting than some printed paper. And first, I want to make a size comparison. I have the Titans Return Deluxe class Hot Rod for you to see. Optimus Prime is a bit bigger. I don't have any Last Night Deluxe figures yet. I think I will buy Berserker and Barricade. These two are entirely new molds, so I think I'll grow on them, but Bumblebee is a no-go. I'll wait for the upcoming Deluxe Bumblebee, which comes in Wave 3, I think? Something like that. Yeah, so far, size comparison. Let's look at Optimus himself. I really dig that alt mode. I have grown on it pretty fast. I overall love the flat nose truck design Generation 1 established, but I think this mode is also pretty fine. Also like the chosen color, like the metallic blue here on the front. We have a mound of silver painted details, like these parts, like the shield over here, and the front grille. Yeah. Better. And also we have a small AllAbout logo here on the side. And I think this mold is pretty detailed. If you look closer, here we have some markings. Western Star. Here we have a door opener. On the front we have this molded little AllAbout logo, which is pretty neat. And also on the tires, here we have small AllAbout logos. Pretty cool. Amount of color in this mode is pretty good. Only thing I would have done is to use the silver paint also on these parts, maybe also on this part, but overall it's okay. Can't complain this much on this mode. So we take off the shield, which can be stored here on this part. Also we have storage for his sword, which stores under here. You just push it in there like this. Pretty great. So much for the weapons. Overall, I think Hasbro made a good progress in designing this figure, because when I remember the first movie, the Optimus Prime figure we got in Leader Class, he was pretty blocky, pretty... he was not really that accurate to his on-screen appearance, and I think, or if you remember what we got with the Revenge of the Fallen Optimus Prime in Leader Class, I think this kind of progress we have over here with the comparison Age of Extinction Prime to Last Night Prime, and my biggest complaint with the Age of Extinction toys was they were too much of shell formers for me. And I think this point is, how can I say, that doesn't bother me that much on the Last Night Optimus Prime. I will show you transformation later. As I said, I think Hasbro made a great progress in designing this figure. If I remember the Age of Extinction first edition Optimus Prime, which I reviewed, I will post the link to the video, or link the video over here for you to see. And the only parts on this Voyager class figure that can be called shell forming is the roof and here side panels. All the other parts you see of the truck mode are pretty good used in transformation to robot mode, and that is pretty great in my opinion. Also, compared to the Age of Extinction mode, where the back section just was, or just became part of the back backpack, that's not the case with this one. So everything you see from the nose over here to the side panels to this parts, all this became feet or legs. So here we have the robot feet folding this together, but you will see in robot mode. And yeah, the upper body is stored inside here. So we take a look inside while I fold this away. Here you can see the shoulder panels, here are the arms. And when I open the side panels up, you can see here is the chest stored, the head is over here, so pretty nice. The arms get into the front of the truck, like this, you see his hands here. Yeah, let's begin transformation, or let's continue transformation as I begun already. Fold this together, they collapse pretty nice. Another viewpoint, like this, pretty good. Then you want to untap the front section, untap these parts, like this. Then you want to untap this side and this side. These packs go in here inside of the upper thighs. So then you want to fold down his legs, untap these parts. Then you want to turn around these parts to the inner side of the legs. Fold down this, fold down this, fold down his feet like this, and turn them around 180 degrees like this. We'll tap in here in these little slots like this. Okay, so then you want to fold down the grill inside this like that, and fold it around so it can connect to the packs on the sides of legs like this. So here we have the left leg, same on the other side like this. Like this. So now you want to turn the upper torso around 180 degrees like this. Fold that in like that. Then you want to fold that on the back. Okay, so untap the shoulder pads like this. Fold down the arms. Slot them in. Fold them down. As for this parts, you want to hinge them. This is a double hinge. Hinge them back like this. Connects pretty well. Also on this pack like this. I love on this figure how many parts are movable, and everything packs in place pretty well. So to continue, we fold out the head and put the chest together. Last step is to move these parts up, which is a pretty great last step, because it feels like you really have the feeling you form his chest, even though it's just a big part you fold up. So but it gives you a satisfying feeling to just move these parts up. Oh, I think, yeah. And here we are in his robot mode. And I think the robot mode itself looks pretty great. It's not that big and chunky with so many stuff hanging around. It's just pretty great designed, in my opinion. Sure, he has some... some big legs, but I think they beef him up pretty great. It's not like you have this whole stuff hanging around pretty loose and coming in the way and looking dumb. I think it's okay. Also, I like how these parts sit flat on the lower arms. Next, what I like is we got a good amount of silver painting here on the shins, on this part, on the chest itself, here on the upper arms. We have also this metallic blue here on this part, here on the arms. Pretty great. But overall, I'm pretty happy with this figure. The transformation itself is really satisfying. I think this figure is a great update on the Age of Extinction Optimus Prime. Also, for a Voyager figure, this figure has 30 steps of transformation. I think this is more than every figure of the Age of Extinction toy line had. I can be corrected, I'm not pretty sure, but it feels like. And also attaching his weapons to him. Like I said, it's not the perfect figure, but overall, I think you will like him.
Aha!
Yeah, also, I guess the weapons could have need more paint apps. They look okay, but if you compare to the artwork, you see these parts are not painted. A bit of red could have been nice. Before I come to a size comparison, I want to show you the movability of this figure, the articulation. So we have the head on a ball joint. You can look to the sides, can look a bit down, can look up. The movement is a bit hindered by these parts, but I think it's still okay. Also, the arms can rotate. We have rotation here. Over 90 degrees of elbow. We can turn the waist. We can move the legs. Rotation here. A little bummer is this part. You can only move the knees to this point. That's not so great, but you can still do some poses with him. Like, I'll try something. I'm not pretty good at posing figures, so that's my try of posing him in a battle stance or something. Maybe he's taking a poo. Could be as well. So, I promised a size comparison, and for this I have the Titans Return Voyager Class Sentinel Prime. Sentinel Prime is a bit higher head-wise, but okay, Prime's antennas are okay. But I think Sentinel Prime feels more bulky and more blocky, which is not bad because I buy Generations figures for their G1 likeness. But if I take them, it clearly feels that Sentinel Prime has a bit more weight to him, so Optimus feels a bit lighter. So that's for Optimus Prime. In my opinion, a good figure. Give him a try. I think you won't be disappointed. And also, I would like you to leave a thumb up, leave a subscription if you want, and be sure to check back to see more of the Transformers The Dark Knight. Yeah, new movie. The Last Knight figures. I think they will follow some figures, like I said, Barricade and Berserk and Megatron. See you again. Until next time.